An East Sacramento neighborhood is saying goodbye to an old and faithful friend today, but that farewell also being marked with some mystery and intrigue.
And Mike DeSalle is live in East Sacramento. Mike, this huge tree seemed fine just a few weeks ago.
Yeah, and we're live right at 35th Street. Let me just show you just how huge this tree was. Look up. You can see blue sky. And this morning, well, the sky was all covered with a huge canopy from this tree. Now you can see how its tree limbs have been basically hacked off, lopped off, and the rest of this tree about to come down tomorrow morning. And if you dig deeper into what happened here, you realize this tree is shrouded in mystery. At first glance, this may appear to be just another tree being chopped down. But don't tell that to Nora Rodriguez.
Just very sad.
Or neighbor Ann Patino.
Part of the family.
Or even stranger Sheila Brown.
Been there forever.
All three are talking about a 75-foot tall old Blue Atlas Cedar tree near the corner of 35th Street and McKinley Boulevard.
It's a beloved tree.
This tree, so beloved, its owner took a picture of it. Children made drawings of it. Others even left handwritten messages like, "Dear tree, I've always loved you. Trees are just wood, but you tree are something to cherish for evs."
People were married under the tree.
But in this tree, there is also mystery. That is because witnesses say just after Easter, this tree began turning brown and dying.
It's like completely dead. All the needles are brown.
Just like that.
Just like that.
And even today, no one appears sure what happened. A gas leak was ruled out, and while there are woodpecker holes, tree crews say they haven't yet seen any potentially deadly tree beetles. Regardless, now take another look, and you'll see why neighbors say this is something more than just a tree. An old friend.
An old friend, yeah. A nice shaded old friend that's not going to be there anymore.
An old friend, soon to be gone forever. And back here live again, you can see the canopy, which is now gone. And come tomorrow morning, crews say they'll be able to remove the rest of this. And to give you just one more example of just how beloved this tree was, the property owner here says a week ago Sunday, the neighborhood held a ceremony to say farewell and, in her words, pay homage to a tree that, quote, served this neighborhood well. Guys.
It just goes to show how attached they are in East Sacramento to all the beautiful trees that canopy the area. Can't help but think maybe what happened to this tree could happen to someone else. So that you're saying they still don't know? Maybe a gas leak or something might have played a role?
Well, you know, the homeowner did have PG&E come over, and she said they went above and beyond to try and see if a gas leak might be involved. And the reason for that is because tree crews, as well as neighbors here, say trees can die suddenly if their roots are exposed to a gas leak. But property owner says there's no evidence whatsoever to suggest there's any type of gas leak here. Instead, they say the only other peculiar thing is that before this tree started to turn, it dropped a whole lot of pine cones. But again, still, no definitive answer as to what happened to a tree that had a huge shade canopy up until this morning. Live at East Sac, Mike DeSalle, KCRA 3 reports.
Yeah, its sheltering shadow is gone now. All right, Mike, thanks.